Hello, I would like to take 2 minutes to three to introduce you to Module 1. This is the home page of our Canvas course. Click on Modules. This is what I'm talking about. The first module is introducing us on fluid properties and concepts. Same video now is in this part. This is the mind map that describes to you what are the different resources, activities, and assessments that we will use for this course. As I said already, this course covers the basic concepts of fluid mechanics, most importantly the transport properties, characterizes the fluids between Newtonian and non-Newtonian, and illustrates some methods that we're actually going to apply on how we're going to measure the viscosity, which is one of the most important properties related to fluid flows. The objective of this module is for us to explain other ideas like the continuum hypothesis, interpret how the transport properties affect the fluid's operations, describe laws that we use to describe viscosity, how we measure the viscosity, and also how we apply them in different other types of flows. Now, very important for you, there is this to-do list. You will have to go through, or you're advised to go through, the reading material as soon as possible. The reading material is listed here. It has specific chapters from the textbook we're using. Some of them are mandatory, some of them are optional. A series of handouts. These notes are also going to develop through our remote or face-to-face meetings. And there are some extra slides that you can use for consultation or not. This is entirely optional. On the way, I'm going to also add more material. Now, this is what you should do before the operation, reading through the reading material. Then we have the first part, which is explore. And in this exploration, there is a very small video, 5 to 6 minutes, of myself describing a home project that has to do with the concepts of the material. There are specific questions that we're going to discuss through the first day of the module. We're going to break into groups, we're going to discuss it, prepare your answers, and come back to do a bigger discussion. There are also a couple of beyond questions that we will try also to touch in that day or later on. We're going to use some polls or surveys to help us out through this first day, and for this you can use the link that is there. Now, from that day on, the first day of exploration, your discussion starts. You have to join your classmates into a group discussion that has to do with concepts of the module. There are three specific questions. What is the most important assumption related to this module? Provide or explain... Oops, wrong module. Go back. Modules. And discussion of fluid properties and concepts. And here we are. So there are three questions. Why gases, fluid, and gases and liquids flow differently? And what is the most prominent mechanism for it that dictates rules this difference? I will ask you to give one unique example of failing the continuity assumption and a way to control and mitigate it. Or to explain briefly the types of non-Newtonian fluids and how we can approximate their viscosity. Remember, these are three different discussions. You can join only one of them, and there are specific guidelines how you're supposed to participate in this discussion. Like in any other assessment tool, we're going to use this rubric to assess your performance. Let's go back. Now, this module also has a quiz, like most of the other modules. Joining this module every time, joining this activity every time, you're going to get 4 to 5 questions out of a question bank. It's an ungraded activity. You can do it as many times, but at the end, to move on to the next module, you have to achieve a 4 out of 4 or a 5 out of 5. Also, very important, keep your notes while you go through the discussion, the introduction, and the quiz, because all of this will come back later in the comprehensive quiz that we talked about in the welcome of the main course. Now, Every module has an individual activity, a homework, an individual micro project. The homework in this case has two questions, but you have to complete both of them, and you have to upload this as one file, as a PDF file. There are instructions here, and sometimes there are specific hints on helping you how you should approach this assignment. And then the last activity, the micro project. Here is the fun part, as I said already. Fun part, but for 5 points per module. You will have to conduct a specific activity at home that is many times related to the exploration activity and sometimes related to the introductory concepts. In all cases, or let's say in most cases, you will have to prepare the podcast yourself. A very short one, 3 to 4 minutes. You can upload the file here, or you can paste a link if you upload it in another medium. You can record it through Canvas, it's up to you, or even your mobile phone, it's up to you. But remember, your micro project will be evaluated by us and your peers as well through this rubric. Like in every rubric, you have to study it, so you know what exactly you have to complete and achieve. Objective of the micro project, as I'm describing here, is that you're able not only to demonstrate that you have understood the concepts, but you're able to apply the concepts in a similar or a different problem than the ones we discussed already. You have to do 6 of them, and most of the times there are plenty of hints how to start into the exploration project. The due dates for every activity are mentioned here. The calendar is spread out, but be very careful. You have to follow the submission plan. Start delaying activities will have some impact through the participation grade, but very important, will make your plan, your schedule more complicated as you move on to the next modules. Having said that, welcome to module 1.